If you look at the United States unemployment rate from 1990 to 2020, you will see that it hovers usually around 5%. In this graph, you see a big spike in 2020 as we entered the recession that was introduced by COVID-19. We also see a big spike in 2009 around the Great Recession. The question, though, whenever we talk about unemployment is, what's the right amount of unemployment that we should have in the economy? Is it 0%, is it 5%, or is it 20%? To get a better idea of what unemployment is or what target unemployment rate we need in the economy, we first have to describe or explain what unemployment is. And then after we explain what unemployment is, I will talk about three types of unemployment that occur in the economy to allow us to understand what a natural unemployment rate is. What is unemployment? Unemployment occurs when a person cannot find a job and is actively seeking a job. So with that as a definition, now we need to talk about, once somebody is unemployed or is actively seeking a job, we will try to define the different types of unemployment that occur in the economy. The first type of unemployment is frictional unemployment. Second is structural unemployment, and then third is cyclical unemployment. So conditional on somebody being unemployed, these are the three types of unemployment that could occur. What is frictional unemployment? Frictional unemployment is the unemployment that occurs due to frictions in the economy. In this situation, people are looking for jobs and the jobs exist. But for some reason, they can't find each other and they cannot match. This is sometimes due to search process. So the process in which we try to look for jobs. We know that in every economy, there's people that are leaving old jobs for new jobs. And then there's also new people entering the labor market, recent graduates, for instance. How do they actually try to find a job is what we call the search process. We have, you know, the internet has made it accessible or easier for us to look for jobs, but that's still a process that we have to undertake. Also, within the market, the labor market, there are also some behaviors that create some friction. For instance, you might find a job and might like the job, however, might go through a negotiation process because you're trying to figure out the best wage for yourself. And the employer is doing the same thing. So although the job exists and the employee exists, there is a friction in agreeing on which wage to go with. And you might not land that job because of that mismatch in the negotiation process. So that's what frictional unemployment is. It's this underlying assumption that the jobs exist and the people to fill those jobs exist, but they can't find each other. Frictional unemployment could be impacted by the economic environment, but also at times by government regulation. So let's talk about economic environment. What do we mean by that? Well, the introduction, as I said, the introduction of the internet has made it easier for us to search for jobs. So the internet has reduced search costs and therefore has decreased the time and cost associated with searching for a job. So the length of frictional unemployment has decreased over time. From the government's perspective, there are some things that some government policies that are introduced that help the labor market on one hand, but also increase frictional unemployment. A good example of that is unemployment insurance. So unemployment insurance is a policy that is designed to help people maintain their living standards in the event that they lose their jobs. So it's a policy with a good intention. It provides people money to sustain their consumption and therefore not impact the overall economy. It provides individuals with time to find the job that they will like and that they will succeed in. And then it prevents the problems of unemployment to spill over into other parts of the economy. However, unemployment insurance also reduces the incentives to find a job quickly. Therefore, unemployment insurance could increase frictional unemployment time. So that in a nutshell is what frictional unemployment is. Next, we will look at structural unemployment. What structural unemployment is and how it's caused is it's caused by changes in the industries within the economy. So an economist by the name of Joseph Schumpeter called this creative destruction. So in every economy, as it evolves, as it innovates, some new industries will evolve and some old industries will become obsolete. And that's the nature of innovation. So if we want a healthy economy, we want creative destruction. But by definition, what that means is in every economy, there are going to be jobs that become obsolete. And those individuals had skill sets that were optimal for previous industries, but now their skill sets are not compatible with these new industries that have evolved. And therefore, they have become structurally unemployed. And if you look at the United States from the 1800s to today, the structure of the industry has changed, and it's the structure of the economy is currently going through a change as well. It used to be that the United States was an agriculture-based economy, but over time, it changed to become an industrialized economy. And industry and manufacturing was the height of the United States and the economic growth involved with it. And then something changed. And what happened in the United States is we started a shift from manufacturing to a service-based economy. And the people that were in manufacturing, their skill sets became obsolete in this service-based economy. And they had to learn how to operate in this new economy. But for a while, they were structurally unemployed. Something that's near and dear to, you know, the people watching this is a couple of years or a couple of decades ago, online education was not a thing. But now we're seeing that the market for online education is increasing and there's a structural change in higher education. So instructors and professors and even students are having to change the way that they consume and produce education. And that is what Joseph Schumpeter called creative destruction. The third type of unemployment is called cyclical unemployment. And this is the unemployment that arises due to the ups and downs of the economy, due to the business cycle. Cyclical unemployment tends to be higher when market demand is lower and therefore firms cannot sell their products. They will let go of people. However, something that people don't realize is cyclical unemployment could actually be a negative number, meaning that we are hiring more people than optimal. This usually happens when the economy is thriving and doing really well, and we end up hiring people for jobs that they are not necessarily skilled at doing. So cyclical unemployment could be a positive or a negative number. We'll look at that in a little bit more detail, but let's look at the recession of 2008. What happened in 2008 is unemployment increased to about 10%. Not only that, the length and duration of unemployment increased to about 18 months. So that brings us to a very important part of our discussion, and that's the definition of the natural rate of unemployment. The natural rate of unemployment is the amount of unemployment that exists in an economy, a healthy economy, regardless of what we try to do, right? And in this example, that amount of unemployment is going to be equal to frictional and structural unemployment, because we know those are going to exist. There's always going to be people looking for jobs. There's always going to be people leaving jobs to find new jobs. And there's always going to be people entering the labor market. So frictional unemployment will exist. And we also know a healthy economy is an economy that innovates. And therefore, it's going to experience creative destruction. And therefore, structural unemployment will always be part of the economy. So U star is what we call it, and U star here is the natural rate of unemployment, and this is the amount of the unemployment that will always exist. If we have unemployment rate that is higher than U-star, then we know we have cyclical unemployment. So let's look at this hypothetical graph over here. Let's say U-star, the natural rate of unemployment in the United States, there's a big debate about it because we don't really know how much frictional and structural unemployment actually is optimal. And that's a function of search process, it's a function of how much innovation is happening, but let's assume it's 5%. And historically, the consensus in the United States is it's about 5%. So if we look at the market and we calculate our unemployment rate and we find that our unemployment rate is 5%, then that tells us that the economy is progressing in a healthy way because we are at our optimal unemployment rate. Now, what if we calculate our unemployment rate and we find that our unemployment rate is actually 13%? Well, if our unemployment is 13% and our natural rate of unemployment is 5%, that means our unemployment is higher than optimal. That means the economy is in a recession, and therefore cyclical unemployment is a positive number, indicating we have more people unemployed in the economy than optimal. Let's look at the other side. What if the unemployment rate was 3% and the natural rate of unemployment is 5%? That means we have a negative cyclical unemployment rate. That means we're hiring 2% more people than optimal. Well, where are we getting these people from? These people are being pulled from the structurally unemployed market. So that means firms are experiencing the economy is experiencing an expansion. Things are going really well. Firms are experiencing profits and they want to employ more people. These people are not optimal because they don't have the skills that are necessary, but they will suffice. They will do. We just need the bodies. And therefore, in expansions, we're more likely to tap into the structurally unemployed individuals, and our unemployment rate will be below the natural rate of unemployment. So that, in a nutshell, is why we usually have an unemployment rate in the United States of about 5% on average. And depending on what our actual unemployment rate is, you will know if we are experiencing a recession or an expansion.